and time saving for doing the test, but not in terms of developing the instrument. Developing the instrument of using multiple choice test is not practical. Yeah, this is general rule for writing multiple choice. Measure the single testing point. Create detectors that are plausible and effective, as I mentioned before. Avoid logical detectors. Use vocabulary grammar consistent with the test taker's level of understanding. Employ similar level of grammatical complexity when writing option. I've shown you some problem there. Include all the necessary information in the stem. Write options that are similar. What to avoid? No option should kill another. Tadi sudah ada contohnya. No item should have more than one key. No option should stick out from the others. Item option should look like a here instead of here. Okay. Once you've developed the item, then ideally, when you have objective test, you need to do item analysis. To check the item quality. Analysis of item quality in terms of the item difficulty. The difficulty level of each item should be assessed. And then how good is the item discriminate between good and poor shooters? And then destructor efficiency, whether all destructors are efficient or not. It means that all of the destructors are chosen by the test takers. If no, and then you consider to remove it. Jadi harus ada semacam trial, uji coba untuk ngecek item facility-nya, item discrimination, and destructor efficiency. Achievement test, biasanya kalau achievement test yang di sekolah itu item difficulty bisa 0.80, jadi 80% yang jawab benar itu wajar karena memang kita pengen memenuhi KKM. Tapi kalau yang untuk test proficiency biasanya enggak, itu ya sekitar 50%an. Jadi memang karena fungsinya harus status menunjukkan item difficulty-nya yang bagus, beda standar antara yang norm sama criteria reference untuk yang item difficulty. Okay, I still have 4 minutes. Any question?
Yes, sir. About the example of we should avoid negative in step either and then I'm still confused about that. I think in the step 22,
sir. Right? 22.
Yes. 22. Yes.
Avoid negative form in the stem and in the option when possible.
Yes.
Yeah. So the stem, the batang soal, if it possible are in positive statement. Jadi kalau bisa memang di positive statement. Dan juga kenapa? Ketika dipilihannya in the alternative, in the option, is also positive. Jadi kalau distance-nya negatif, jangan kemudian distance-nya negatif juga ya. Tadi kan kita menghindari double apa namanya? Double negatif. In the stem. Di stem memang tidak boleh ada double negatif. Not and then except. Itu juga dihindari. Kemudian, if possible, you make a stem. Even though the text is actually stated as positive, and then in the stem, you provide not, or using what we call the antonym, and then in the option, the correct answer, you also provide the negative one. Jadi sebisa mungkin itu juga dihindari. Jadi distance-nya yang negatif, and then di option-nya juga dibuat negatif sekalian. Itu memang kalau bisa memang dihindari. Memang sekarang saya tidak punya contoh sih untuk membuat menjadi lebih jelas, tapi sebisa mungkin hal seperti itu. Jadi fungsinya gini, you develop an item not to confuse the student, just to make it complex, complicated, simply to distract the student. Fungsinya kan bukan itu. You develop the test to assess the student's understanding, like say, reading comprehension. Apakah dengan membuat menjadi lebih rumit dalam arti kompleksitinya itu akan membantu untuk mengukur kemampuan reading comprehension atau tidak? Apalagi kalau di dalam listening itu akan lebih sulit lagi, listeningnya kalimatnya positif-positif, kemudian di dalam di soalnya itu menggunakan dibuat negatif, itu akan menjadi semakin confusing kepada student-nya. Itu harus dilihat, terutama di dalam listening itu yang akan menyusahkan. Oke. Coba nanti kalau saya ketemu soal yang bisa jadikan contoh akan lebih mudah itu.
Yes, thank you.
Oke, okay. It already. I have to end the class.
Sir.
Yep. Siapa?
It's Nani, sir.
Bukan.
How do we measure authenticity?
Saya sudah di telepon Kak Prodi, bentar. Halo, assalamualaikum. Pagi, Pak. Sorry. Geser lagi. Ya, berangkat. Iya, siap. Oke, ya. Sudah di telepon yang sudah mereka siap ujian. Gimana, Mas?
How do we measure the feasibility, authenticity, and validity of the task?
How do we measure the feasibility of the task? Feasibility can be checked. This is self judgment. Jadi dinilai sendiri oleh Anda as the task developer. Check this list. You try to answer this question by yourself. Check sendiri. Okay, this is about feasibility. How about validity? The validity, of course, it would be better if you use content validity. It means that you develop the kisi-kisi, you consult it to the expert in assessment. Dicek, minta orang lain untuk ngecek. This is to check the validity. How about the reliability? Yeah, of course, you do the trial, diuji cobakan. After that, you check using internal consistency. Let's say korbah alpha. Okay. The simplest one to check the validity is using expert judgment. Jadi penilaian orang ahli di bidang itu. Itu pertama. Jadi ditunjukkan itu itemnya di kisi-kisi seperti apa, dia akan mengomentari. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. I have to end the class now. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm so sorry. End the class now.
Thank you, sir.
I will send the PowerPoint presentation after it.
Thank you, sir.